we go to Albania, which was controlled by the Russians at the time. Russians on every corner, tanks, you know, Russian soldiers. And this was a very, very poor country at the time. And everywhere we looked, there was Michael Jordan jerseys, Michael Jordan billboards, Michael Jordan on taxis, Michael Jordan in the paper, the language that I couldn't read.
I think there was a great connection between art and sport when it came to Michael Jordan. He was so incredibly athletic that it bordered on the on being almost balletic, you know, being like a ballet dancer in midair.
Air was there, and fans jammed Celland Arena just to get a glimpse. Michael Jordan's pregame stretch is an event. The guy is that popular.
Right around 1990, the former Bulls public address announcer and most recent retiree, Tommy Edwards, had left the Chicago Bulls to go to Boston for another job. And I applied for the job, and I was lucky enough to become the public address announcer for the Chicago Bulls. Unbeknownst to me, the following year, they were going to win their first world championship.
Most impressive things about Michael was his competitive edge. When he stepped on the floor, he was ready to kill. He would test you to see if you were ready to compete.
You know, as long as the team is successful, all my individual accolades come along with if the team is successful. I'm not searching for any individual accolades. If it happens, it just happens. But if I don't win it, I just don't win it. I'm not really trying to set that as a goal for me this season. I think more or less the team wants to be successful, and that's what I want for the team.
Obviously, Tex Winter coached Michael Jordan longer than anyone. And Tex was constantly pushing team at him, and triangle offense.
He had his hands down on his knees. He looked up at us, and there was five of us, like me, Glenn Rice, Brian Shaw, Keith Askins, Ronnie Cyclist, I think Steve Smith. We walked over, and we were like, we're talking junk, and he looks up and he says, "Young fellas, I played 36 holes of golf today, and I was just gonna chill, but now I'm gonna kick your ass."
Do a lot of charity work.
Yeah, I started receiving criticism for not giving back enough, and I guess maybe that's due to because I don't publicize a lot of things that I try to do in terms of giving back to the community. It's just something that I don't seek publicity for.
The Michael Jordan Foundation, run by his mother, has made a big impact on the many children's charities it supports.
Il a pulvérisé le record d'Elgin Baylor, 35 points en une mi-temps, et c'était très clairement, on l'a vu après quand on est allé à la conférence de presse et tout, c'était sa façon de marquer le territoire, en disant, ouais, on est en finale, vous allez voir, vous allez me voir, moi, vous allez voir.
Michael, the Bulls did it last year. I came out, gave you the MVP trophy. Bulls won the NBA championship, came out, gave you the MVP trophy. Bulls won an all regular season this year, came out, gave you the MVP trophy. Here I am again. There's only one man in the history of the NBA that's won the NBA Finals MVP trophy 2 years in a row.
And I just remember thinking to myself, man, this guy is unlike any player I've ever seen before. He didn't have any weaknesses. He was strong. He was quick as could be. He jumped like nobody I'd ever seen. And he was ultra competitive.
And then at the end of the clock, there was about 3 or 4 seconds to go, and he shot a jump shot. And just when he released it, he just ran to the locker room. He hit the jump shot and nothing but net. And we just stood and looked at him like, you got to be kidding me.
Yeah, I like Mike. He's my favorite basketball player, the best in the world. He's a great inspiration. I like him very much, you know. And this is my first time. I wish all my life I could meet him and now I get my chance.
I got the opportunity to play against Michael Jordan in 1992 in the pre-Olympics in Portland, Oregon.
He wanted to beat you and embarrass you. And that's what he did. He went out there, he beat us, and he did embarrass us in a few games.
I'm not here campaigning for the best player in the world or in the history. I'm not saying that, you know, because everybody plays differently in different eras.
You could see that there was a painting, but it wasn't there. It was missing. So I asked him, I said, Mike, I said, what was over there? It looks like there was a painting there. He goes, oh, yeah, that was one of my paintings. It's on loan to the Louvre. Except he says Louvre. It's on loan to the Louvre, you know. Okay, they're borrowing your painting. Okay.
You can look at it and get selfish and say, gosh, why is he leaving? He's in great shape. He could go and play for another 10 years. However, you know, it's not about us. It's about Michael and his family. And if that's what makes him happy, you know, more power to him.
You know, my network, NBC, was totally wrong for giving a platform to a guy that Jordan played golf with and lost money to, allegedly. A lot of money, didn't pay him. That's not our business. That's Jordan's business and the guy Askenius's business. Why would we talk about it during the semifinals of the NBA on national television? And I said at the time it was embarrassing. Embarrassing. And I almost got fired for that.